Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much. On this presentation, we will discuss about production scheduling optimization to minimize mix span and number of machines with mixed integer linear programming. This research was conducted by Farizal, Gabriel, Rahman, and Rinaldi, coming from Department of National Engineering, University of Indonesia. This presentation will consist of introduction, methodology, case study, and end up with conclusion. Introduction. Production scheduling. Production scheduling is one important part on production because it's related directly to profit. Production scheduling means how could we use the line in efficient way so it will reduce the cost. When we reduce the cost, it means we can improve. We can reach the profit. Scheduling can take many type. For instance, how many machine will be used, or how many product will be produced, and what is the range of product. So that's why scheduling has many setting. To represent this production scheduling, usually we use one way is using mathematical model, which has mainly two parts, which is objective function and constant. Objective function means the goal that we want to achieve, and the constant is about what is the setting of the production that should not be break. This is the model that we come up. The model have two objective function, which is minimize the number of machine and at the same time minimize the max span. This objective function should be traded off, meaning that if the cost to use the machine is big, so the model will force using as less as possible the number of machine. But if we have the max span as a target, meaning that should be small, so we can use the machine as many as possible to achieve the minimum max span. We have on this model 17 constraints, constraint 2 up to constraint 18 here. Constraint 2 and constraint 3 tell about one machine is only can perform one job at one time. And then constraint 2 is about once one job is doing by a machine, another job could not be done at the same time, meaning that two job could not be overlap one another. Constraint 16, 17, 18 is binary, meaning that this full force, whether we will do the job or not, or we will use the machine or not. Okay, for using this model for many problem, or when to use this model for many run, so we translate the model into a computer language, which is Lingo here. And in order to use the coding, the computer language, we should verify and validate the model. So we must verify and validate the coding so that it will exactly represent the model, the mathematical model we develop. So verification means we run the coding. If the running is can come up with the result, it means the verification is proof. And validation means we must make sure that the result coming from the coding for the computer program is correct. So that's why for validation we must make a small scale problem, and then we calculate the small scale problem manually and run with the model, run with the computer code. If the result coming out from the computer code is the same with the result coming out from the manual calculation, it means the validation is proved. Here from the verification we use for product using will be processed for two machine, and this is the setting. And we, for the validation, we come out with this exactly the same result from the calculation from the manual calculation and with the coding using Lingo. Here we see that from the two line available, we just use line two, and the max span is exactly the same, which is 35.3 hours. Sorry, 35.7 hours. Here the same. So it means the coding is ready to use. So case study. For this case study, we start with doing a product forecasting demand. It means that what is the number of product we will produce. Here we come up with this result. We have six product with its own production, with its own need. And then we use six of we use we use four we use apa we use four machine with its own capability. Machine A can make a 1500 box per shift, and for every hour can make 240 boxes. Study result. First, this problem, which is producing this amount of product using this four line, is performed by subjective method, meaning that the schedule is made by an expert, a skillful staff. So we come up with this result. Use for the four line the all machine we have, and machine one will process product one, machine B will process product six and four, machine C, and so on and so forth. For this arrangement, we will come up with max span 185.2 hours, and then we translate this result to the Gantt chart, and we come up with that only machine B and C has a almost 100% utilization. For machine A, it just have around 80%, and machine D even it has less than 50% utilization, which means that this scheduling it actually is not that good because many idle of machine, meaning that the cost is there. So because time limitation, we continue with our result with the objective minimizing max span and number of machine. Here the recommendation is just use one line, which is machine D, machine number four, which come up with max span 268.3 hours. I'm sorry, 295.4 hours. This max span is indeed more. This max span is longer than the first max span, but if we look at the Gantt chart, the utilization of the machine is 100%, and we just use, even though we have four machine, we just use the combination, just use one machine. Which one is better? We do the cost comparison, and we come up with this indeed that the two objective model we have can save around 26%, which is this is better. Thank you very much for the time.